Okay. Sister Samira, inshallah, is going for Umrah, and she has a serious issue that the menses is continuous. Now it's over 15 days. As long as it was not like that before, so the excessive bleeding when the color and the odor has changed, that will be treated as istihada. Istihada is known as irregular bleeding. Gynecologists and doctors do not normally distinguish between hayd or istihada. It's just bleeding, okay? But it makes a big difference in Islam because it will determine whether you can pray or not, fast or not, and perform tawaf or not. Al-istihada does not prevent a woman from offering all the acts of worship. Only the menses, the monthly period. The irregular bleeding afterward is treated as istihada, where the woman would wash herself and perform tahara, wudu, prior to every prayer after the time has entered. So when you hear the adhan, you make wudu and you pray for each prayer. And also you can with the same wudu pray the relating nawafil before or after until the next fard, where you will be required to make a new wudu. The same applies to at-tawaf. The only pillar of Umrah which requires tahara is at-tawaf. Al-Umrah consists of three pillars. Ihram, which is the intention of commencing into the act of Umrah or Hajj, in your case is Umrah, and it will be announced by saying Labbayka Umratan. And then you start avoiding all the restrictions of Ihram, cutting the hair, removing the nails, covering the face for a woman, using any scented substances, wearing any makeup or perfume, etc. For men, wearing, covering the head, or wearing any stitched clothes, or wearing any perfume, in addition to whatever we mentioned in the case of women, removing any hair or nail, and obviously having an intimate relationship or the introduction to that. That is entirely restricted during Ihram. Then at-tawaf is the second pillar in order, which requires tahara. In your case, just simply make wudu and perform tawaf, because it's called istihada. If it is hayd, it is different. You have to wait. As in the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, when she performed hajj with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and she performed hajj with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and when she entered Mecca, he noticed that she was crying. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I figured it out. You must have started your period. She said, Naam ya Rasulullah. He said, don't cry. This is something that happens to every woman. He didn't choose it. Do everything that the hajj would do except for tawaf. Wait until you're clean, perform ghusl, and do tawaf. So in your case, you're coming already with an irregular bleeding. Treat it as istihada and perform your tawaf. And then the sa'i and your umrah is fine, insha'Allah Azza Jal. The period would not diminish your word of the umrah or the hajj, because this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created you with. It is out of your control, okay? Women who may start their period, the actual period, which would actually prevent them from performing tawaf, they must avoid performing tawaf unless. Nowadays, with the expansion in the haram and the construction, I heard that the haram can only accommodate 22,000 at a time, every 1 hour. My God, I cannot really imagine how would this happen, but Allah will deal with it. Allah will take care of His haram. When you expect 3 to 4 million people, last year about 4 million people performing hajj, and there is one day, everybody wants to do tawaf. Then on the farewell tawaf, everybody wants to even do tawaf. How would this happen? Okay, so for a woman, I'm just using this as a reference. Later on, we'll expand on this, maybe in an independent episode, to speak about the proper way to do it with this crowd. So the woman who must leave right now, because she has to catch a flight, she has to join her company. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, because of the necessity, even with the menses, perform ghusl, wear your pad and perform tawaf, because this is a necessity, even with the period.